Welcome to the first annual hospitality conference at Pakistan Travel Mart. My name is Lashley Pulsifer. I am the Chief Marketing Officer for Hashu Group. And this is one of the first things that I decided to do in my job at Hashu Group was to sponsor PTM. I believe that this is a really important event for bringing together people from the travel industry to meet each other, to have conversations about where we go. Today, we want to have several conversations about different topics in travel and tourism and relevant to hospitality. Our first panel is about the pioneers of hospitality. So I'm going to introduce to you my colleague, Mr. Azam Jamil. He's our VP, Head of Learning and Development at Hashu Group, but has worked for many other groups in Pakistan as well. I'm going to have you come up. And our first panel is about the pioneers of hospitality. So as Azam introduces the rest of the panelists, we've brought together people and who represent organizations that have been in Pakistan, in this industry since the beginning, and have really paved the way for all the growth and development that we're seeing now. So we want to talk about kind of that contribution that they've made and then where we're going. Then we have a panel about the digital landscape in tourism, and I think this is going to be a really exciting panel. It's our next panel, a second panel. And at the end, we'll be talking about budget tourism and the underserved market there, because there's a lot of space for growth in budget tourism, and we have some great panelists. So I'm going to turn over to my esteemed colleague and let him take it from there.
Thank you so much, Lashley. Assalamu alaikum ji. Let me start by inviting guests on our panel today. Mr. Amanullah Qureshi is Chief of Corporate Development for PIA. Krishna, welcome. I have two colleagues in the panel, one new colleague and one ex-colleague, Mr. Zubair Surti. Zubair works for Tourism Promotion Services as the owning company of Serena Hotels in Pakistan. Zubair and I have worked together for about two decades. Zubair is also the chairman of the Pakistan Hotels Association. And last but not least, as you will see, is Haseeb Girdezi, who is a wonderful friend and colleague. Haseeb is the Vice President of Operations for the Hashu Group, and need I say, a dear friend and a wonderful colleague. Our discussion today is something that has been very close to my heart for four decades. As my age would reflect, I've been in hospitality for 38 years. And out of these 38 years, I spent 18 years going overseas to travel shows like ITB and WTM, trying to sell Pakistan. And one of the things we sold was Mohenjo-daro. They said, gee, there is Pakistan's greatest asset is Mohenjo-daro. It's 5,000 years old. And I went to Berlin and London for 13 years to sell Mohenjo-daro. And on the 14th year, I realized that I hadn't been there myself. And that's the issue. We become sellers, but we don't experience the product. We try to sell something that we haven't seen ourselves. We also have another misconception, in my opinion. When the word tourism comes to mind, the word Gora comes to mind. And we feel that a tourist is somebody who's of foreign origin. The Taj Mahal has 4 million visitors in a year. Out of that, 5% are foreigners. 95% Indians go to see the Taj Mahal. The Grand Canyon in the US, where I have lived many years, has 5 million visitors. 4 million out of those are Americans. So it's rather unfair that if we are expecting other people to come and see this beautiful country when we haven't seen it ourselves. This event, to me, I think, is a wonderful first step. And tourism is not about Hashu or Serena or Awari. Tourism is about Pakistan. There are no brands here. There's a country here. Friends from the travel trade, the travel agencies, the airlines, we're all Pakistan. And we all must work together. It's not about brands, it's not about revenues, it's not about meeting budgets. It's about working together. And in my 38 years, if I was to pinpoint one weakness in our system, that would be that we have not synergized. We don't sit under one roof. When was the last time the CEOs of the 5 or 6 hotel brands in this country sat together under one roof? I don't know. If anybody of you knows, I'd be happy to hear that. So it's time to get together. And I think the Pakistan Travel Mart is a wonderful step, or the wonderful first step for us to become together. Because tourism is about Pakistan. Tourism is not about a hotel company. It's not about a travel agency. And it's not about an airline. So that was just my take. I stand corrected. People can disagree with me, but this is my personal feeling. And I'm going to start with Mr. Zubair Surti. The Pakistan Hotel Association sounds very good, but I need to ask Zubair, and I expect Zubair to be honest today, and tell us that what does the PHA do, and what should it be doing? Has it succeeded in getting all of us together? Has it succeeded in promoting Pakistan as a tourist destination? Or is it another bureaucratic organization that does paperwork all day long? Zubair?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The first question I have been given, that how the hospitality industry has grown over the year. Since big, I think there are only 3 major contributors to the hospitality industry. You know, Serena, Hashu, and Awari. There is no new investment coming in Pakistan because of the heavy and long-term investment required for the hotel industry to reach at a break-even point of 20 years. So there is a need to build hotel in Karachi and other major cities, although the existing hoteliers are expanding their hotels throughout Pakistan, but there is no new investment except in Lahore, I think. There is no, since last 30 years, there is no new hotel in Karachi. Karachi is growing as far as the population is concerned, but no. I am affiliated with the Serena since last 4 decades, and I know contribution of our group and Hashu group. Secondly, the importance of PHA. PHA is the only recognized representative body registered with the Ministry of Commerce. But due to certain limitation from the and non-cooperation of the local tourist department, we are unable to increase our membership strength. But although we are representing at all government levels to hotel, to represent the issues of the hotel, just like latest issue of the sales tax in Sindh, that hotel is have to pay 17% on supplies and allow 13% only. The 4% the hotels located of the Sindh, they are bearing unnecessarily on part of the government. But we are fighting with the government, and also we are also approaching to Chief Minister Sindh, Sardar Ali Shah, but results are negative because I think there are major hotels are located in Mari, Naran, Kagan, and Swat, but there is none of them a member of PHA because of the local illegal association running parallel to the PHA. But So far, whatever issues we are receiving from the hotel, we are representing to hotels. And last month, we also had a meeting with the Sardar Minister for Tourism.
Precious PIA. Three wonderful words that come and hit us every morning. I have been associated with the airline indirectly, and I knew at one time PIA played a huge role in the promotion of tourism. I visited the PIA office in London last week, and it was a little depressing. I didn't see one promotional document about Pakistan in that entire office. Today, our diplomatic offices around the world, the people there are not qualified to sell Pakistan. They don't have a single document that would encourage somebody to come to a country which is already handicapped because people have this perception of law and order. And on top of that, if we sort of admit defeat ourselves, that adds to the problem. So, Krishi sir, what can you do to help us?
First of all, I really thank PTM for organizing this particular event. And I think these initiatives were missing altogether. And that's the reason of declining the airline industry in Pakistan as well. So this is something great which has been organized. And the second thing coming towards that, Pakistan International Airline is nothing different than the other airline industries in the world. There is always, you know, a product life cycle. We are presently having great initiatives, and our present management is really committed. We're going for a turnaround program. Even our fleet plan is a very forward-looking fleet plan. We're going to change the average age of the aircraft. We are going to adopt the new technology. And we are restructuring the organization altogether. And you will see very soon the vibrant things and the agility within the PIA and onto the rest of the network as well. So no promises, but you can see from the media, you will see the hype. There is a new team altogether. They have taken a lot of initiatives, and it will happen. And the second thing is, Pakistan, in Pakistan, tourism and the aviation industry goes hands in hands. Despite the fact you were talking about the 40 years of legacy, I talk about 70 years. You know, we introduced the air safari services. We introduced the helicopter services in the areas where nobody could have approached. And we still have that initiative and versatility with us. We would like to partner with you to go to that areas which are yet to be explored in the world. And at the same time, we believe that not only the industry can prosperous that way, but the economy of the country, which is just the 7% for the time being of the GDP growth, can go all the way up there.
Thank you. Krishna, thank you. Krishna, let me, I don't know half the people in this hall, but let me assure you on behalf of everybody that nothing would make us happier than to see PIA get back to where it was.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
There is no question, because PIA exists in our DNA. It's a part of our bloodstream. And I don't know these people, but I'm telling you that the minute PIA gets there, you will have every person on your side. That is my assurance to you.
And I really thank you, because this is the confidence which has given us the boost that we can really make it a turnaround altogether. And you will see in near future, the initiatives which we have taken, they are going to deliver their dividends in all that.
Wonderful, wonderful. Haseeb, the Hashu Group arguably has the largest hospitality footprint. I'm also aware, but I'll let you share what's the plan for the future. The service industry, other than the fact that it's the right industry to be in, is a huge job provider. Nothing provides more jobs than the service industry, anywhere in the world. So I'm going to allow Haseeb to tell us where the Hashu Group stands today, and what do we have to look forward to come 2018 and beyond.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you, Azam, Surti Saab, and Amanullah Saab. Dekhen, as far as Hashu Group is concerned, you would see it is a home for anybody coming to Pakistan. Because if you see from Peshawar to Karachi, this is has a spread. It has three brands, luxury brand like Marriott, PC Hotels, and then Hotel One. Now, you would also see that we are at the locations where it did not make commercial sense. As Suti Saab has said, any good location in Pakistan will still take you 20 years for repay back of the investment. But you will also see that there are people who are visionary in Pakistan, who are very patriotic, who thinks beyond commercial need also. And you would see, I will give you the two hotels. One is Muzaffarabad, and the other was Gawadar. These were the two hotels which were, we knew it from the very beginning that there are no commercial need. But these area needed them because the government and the functionaries, they asked that, you know, that we need to develop these areas. So we need to have an accommodation because to develop these, one of the major need of the international companies are that you should have an accommodation over there. So here comes Hashu Group, they come forward and they built the hotels and made sure that they are international standards. So anybody coming in, so there's an ambassadorship of Pakistan. You know, we if you look at the direct employment, we are 5,000 employees in management and different categories. But don't forget that the indirect employment is huge. You have a supplier who supplies you the food items. You have the interior designers who does that, the furniture maker, the rice growers, the ice cream, and food industry. It's all go hand in hand. And I am very, very pleased to advise you that going forward with the same philosophy, that commercial is one part, but the other part is to have a footprint of hospitality in entire Pakistan. We are built this year, you would see, inshallah, 2018, you will see another four PC hotels, one in Azad Kashmir, which is Mirpur Azad Kashmir, which is on the waterfront of Mangla Dam. Now, let me tell you why this hotel was conceived. It is very important for the panelists and the audience to understand. It was suggested that Pakistan having a little bit challenge with the security. So Azad Kashmir, Mirpur has got a beautiful stadium out there where they wanted to make Azad Kashmir and the Mirpur as the cricketing destination. And that cricketing destination cannot happen until unless there is an accommodation available. And that's where Mr. Hashwani came forward and said, I'm ready to help if this helped the country by doing that. But you would see that we are almost about to finish next year, but the stadium has not yet even started. So the commitment and the things that happens is on one side, the private entrepreneurs are helping, but on the other side, the government also need to help building the image. Other thing is that you have at least 18 to 20 channels when you sit in the evening for a cup of tea and you see everybody thinks Pakistan is the worst country to be in. I disagree. Absolutely not. It is one of the finest country to live in. It's richness, you have got four seasons, you have got food, fruit, vegetables and all that. Look at the countries who have got oil and gas. You think when the food shortage will come, they will eat gas or water, petrol? God has blessed us with places that safari and the helicopters can take you over there. The other hotel that is coming up is in Multan because we feel that South Punjab is growing economically and needs lodging facility there. Now, there was, if you see that about some of my colleagues and the audience would know that Malam Jabba was talked about at least 20 years back, hotel at Malam Jabba, hotel at Malam Jabba. So I'm very pleased to advise you that we are now taking up the management of PC Malam Jabba, which will become Pearl Continental Hotel Malam Jabba and would open October next year, 2018, and we will host the first international skiing competition. So, and the fourth hotel is coming in Peshawar in Hayatabad. And this is going to be a mixed-use development, which is going to be a shopping mall and also a hotel. And in coming these four hotels, I think minimum we would give a direct employment of almost 2,000 people, different 2,000 families. And at the same time, the economic situation would generate. Out of our corporate social responsibility, we'd like to employ as much as possible the local talent over there to groom them, to use the local vendor, use the local suppliers so that we give back to the community. Because, yes, obviously, initially we may have to take a team over there to fix it, but then we like to train the community over there so that they could get the best benefit out of the economic activity that will happen in their own respective areas.
Thank you, Asif. I had originally planned, that we will do less of the talking, and now I'm just opening this. I'm sure you have a lot of questions. Just raise your hand. Somebody will bring you the mic. Please address your question to a particular panel member so that that panel member knows that he has to respond. Jahanzeb Saab.
Regarding the Mohenjo-Daro, the Mohenjo-Daro is the heritage site of UNESCO's heritage sites and well known all over the world. Even the Japan academic books studying Mohenjo-Daro in Japan. Because Mohenjo-Daro is the only 3 hours visit time. You cannot overstay. Maybe some researcher want to spend there 1 week, that is another story. We sell the Mohenjo-Daro since 40 years. You have a daily flight, Karachi, Mohenjo-Daro, and Mohenjo-Daro, Karachi. Now we don't have. Maybe you are a PIA man. Maybe I will tell you something because I am, since 40 years, I'm in the ground in Pakistan tourism, right? So we don't have a flight for Mohenjo-Daro. We have to fly Sakhar. Then I send my vehicle, my man, from Larkana to pick the people who want to visit the Mohenjo-Daro when I was there. And then from Mohenjo-Daro, they fly in the evening, again, not direct to Karachi. Then they have to be fly back to Sakhar, very long distance. So it will 1 hour flight, it will take you 2 and 3 hours flight.
Krishna, please respond.
First of all, thank you very much. To start with, the acknowledgement regarding the PIA. And of course, because you have the affection and the love for PIA, that's why you're that much concerned as well. You already know that PIA is running in losses altogether. I was traveling initially, in my initial days, I used to travel with the aircraft, and we used to travel 1 or 2 odd passengers onto the same destinations. It was almost the whole aircraft was empty. So we can provide you with the charter flights. If you can always contact our charter, you know, section. You can come to my office, we can discuss, I can reach to you for that. But charter flights are on demand, and they're very much available. You can talk to us onto this, it really makes the, you know, cost benefit, we are going to do that. No problem. Of course, the second thing, you have talked about the Vietjet thing. You must appreciate the fact that PIA is not hampering its schedule. Rather, we have to pay through our nose to have these wet lease operations. And that's the reason I told you that we want to reduce the average age of the fleet now, and we want to induct more aircraft. And the management is committed. And you will see very soon that our indigenous capability with our own brand, with everything in place, will do. And you must consider this thing as a fact as well, the national aviation policy. And, you know, so many domestic carriers, they even do not operate on those areas, even till date. Despite the fact we are committed, we are considered. And the latest about the northern area, you must be aware, in the October, the Honorable Aviation Advisor had already a meeting with the Chief Secretary over there, and we are about to operate the flights even from Lahore and from Karachi to that area directly, so that.
Well done, thank you.
It's already there.
Krishna, thank you very much.
Assalamu alaikum, ji. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Umar Farooq, ji. I belong to Mansara, Hazara, and land of opportunities and tourism. My question PIA, pe to main sara din ek alag discussion kar sakta hu yahan baith ke. PIA is another topic for another day. But I want to ask a question to Haseeb Girdezi Saab, actually. First of all, I think the news that you are giving us, I run a first travel and tourism incubation out of Hyderabad. I think this is a great news for the country. Mera question aapse sirf ye hai ki aap Hyderabad, Peshawar mein ja rahe hain, mashallah, you are expanding. How do you see CPAC playing a role in this? Hyderabad being the CPAC tourism gateway hub. And I think I was asking you a question and we didn't finish that conversation. Maybe the room can hear it. When you think about Kahan, Naran, when you think about Nathiagali, Tindiani, we don't see Hashu Group really there. What will it inspire you to come and bring that kind of a level of hospitality and that standard in Kahan, Naran, because it's behangam, jise ek lafz use hota hai, wahan pe hotels to ban rahe. Lekin there's no service there. You said it's service-based industry. We got a lot of people who need to be employed. So I just want you to comment on that, please. Thank you.
First of all, I'm grateful that you have asked these questions because I missed out into my briefing. You know, we are very much the Galyard Development Authority. We are very much in touch. And since you represent from KPK, so let me tell you that we have been approached by the government very directly and officially, and we have actually inspected all the sites that they have, which are right now not running professionally. We may take over. We are in the planning of MOU with them. It's not final yet. What I gave you was what I can commit here, that opening next year. Then is Gilgit-Baltistan. We are very much in touch with them. We have the list of at least 22 properties that Gilgit-Baltistan has, which... Now, the question is, when these were built, they were not built on a very commercial savvy thing. So there are 3 rooms on one location, there are 6 rooms on another location, and right now being used by the senior government officers whenever they go, their families go. So there's a lot of cost of this to the government. And you will see over the last couple of years, I'm very, very proud on Gilgit-Baltistan government, the way they have promoted Gilgit-Baltistan. I mean, this year, we had so much of demand in that side that people were even living in their tents because there was no enough rooms. And we're very sensitive about it. Hunza and other areas, we already have the land banks. And next time when I'll be sitting here, I'm sure I'll be giving the list of the properties in these areas which Hashu Group is already had built or would be building in future. Thank you.
Umar, from a personal point of view, we strongly believe that no matter how many properties you build, you need human resource to run them, okay? And it is my commitment to you that I will volunteer my services to come and train your people there, okay? We need to get the younger children ready to look up because they are the future of Pakistan. You know, Haseeb and I are going to be gone. Me earlier, Haseeb later. But we need the kids, and you'll have our support in training children and these young graduates all over Pakistan. That's our commitment to you, okay? One last question.
This is Abdullah. I'm head of brand of Pakistan International Airline. I don't have a question, rather a suggestion, in fact. From theoretical standpoint, we have figured everything out that, you know, we have to promote tourism in Pakistan. Everything goes neat and to be hand in hand, airlines, hospitality business, service industry, everything has to be synced. From practical standpoint, that's not the case. The thing is, in order to promote the tourism in Pakistan, every activity related needs to be aligned together. What happens is that, you know, you just mentioned that, you know, ek will hoti hai aur ek actually action hota hai jo uske upar hota hai, that, you know, you wanted, there was a need ke Mirpur ke andar international cricket stadium hona chahiye, and you moved ahead and you did your part, but the other part was not completed. Similarly, 4 years ago, there was a meeting in the highest levels of the government in Pakistan decided that, you know, in order to promote tourism, everything needs to go in hand, and, you know, the airline will do its part, the hotel industry will do its part, the visa authorities will do its part, and, you know, we were asked, KG, aap apne logo ko change karke Pakistan ko more prominent kare, aur humne, as you can see, we did that. Instead of getting 3 letters, we made Pakistan boldly, and, you know, we started putting Pakistan prominently on our aircrafts just to promote Pakistan as a destination. But from practical standpoint, that does not happen because aapke visas bahut zyada strict hain, aapke law and order situation ke liye aapka media continuously itni negativity outside project karta hai ke wo cheezein hoti nahi hai. Government ke end ke upar bahut sari cheezein nahi hoti. For example, abhi aapne London ki baat ki. If I put Pakistan flyers over there, and if someone actually arrives in my office, wants to go to Pakistan, now he would have to go through a lot of trouble to get Pakistani visas. When in my previous role, I was the product owner of Far East, we us time pe announced that Karachi is the world's cheapest city for shopping. And there were a lot of travelers from Indonesia, from Malaysia, who wanted to travel to Pakistan while going to Jeddah for Umrah. And they wanted to stay in Pakistan to do one day of shopping. They couldn't get the permissions. So my humble suggestion would be that there are things that the government can do, and there are little things that the government will actually do. Please make an association, make a body representation yourself to get things together. This is just my suggestion.
I would like to make a comment on this, which is a very good. You see, when you talk about the London office, the London consulate is no different than the Pakistani. They should also have a Pakistan on them and not any bureaucratic thing. I tell you, our group as an individual represent in quite a number of travel marts, Arabian Travel Marts and the World Travel Mart, Berlin Travel Mart. You know, when we go there, yesterday I saw there is a Malaysian and there is a Thai, booth here. Both the counselors were here. But whenever we go, neither a Pakistani consulate or a bureaucrat or ambassador come to those to appreciate us as to what we are. This year, what a good thing was told to me by Ali Bhai, who was sitting over here, somebody who has done this PTM. They have already acquired a space of 2,000 square meters in Arabian Travel Mart as a Pakistan pavilion. My request would be that the PIA should be part of it. I assure you, I would request Lashley, who is our chief commercial officer, to be part of it. We would like Serena to be part of it. We like every stakeholder from Pakistan to sit in the Pakistani stand and not make their own dead inch ki masjid jise kehte hain. So let's give ourselves a commitment here that at ATM, which is in May next year, we all would be sitting together under one umbrella, which is Pakistan, and nothing else.
Thank you, sir. Okay, thank you very much. Let me... No, we don't have time. 5 minutes,
we don't have
5 seconds.
We really need to move on.
One question which will help. Do you know how many travel agents registered in Pakistan working for bring tourists into Pakistan and working for tourists sent outside Pakistan? Do you know the numbers? No, Jazef Saab will tell you. You know, approximately 2,500 travel agents registered along with the TAP. Only 20 to 25 travel agent tour operators are working to bring tourists in Pakistan. This is the answer to your question.
Okay.
Second thing is, do you know the former name of PIA? I would like to talk about PIA, whatever the Jazef Saab and Azam Saab talked. Do you know the former name of PIA? And who was the first shareholder of Orient Airways? Qaid-e-Azam. And it was registered before the partition.
Thank you, Zubair. Thank you. Okay, Ji. We closed this panel on working together. And let me give you the latest wonderful example of people working together. Samsung's most profitable phone for 2018. Please understand what I'm saying. Samsung's most profitable phone for 2018 is the iPhone X, because they make 75% of that phone. So the more iPhone sells, the more money Samsung makes. Now, these are the two giants of mobile phones, and they're working together. And we can't sit under one roof. Yeah. Thank you very much. Amen.